Well, we're officially halfway through the show now. Please welcome to the stage the reigning Miss Gay Missouri 1982, Vanessa Vincent.
First of all, I want to give a very, very, very special thanks to someone in my life who's meant a lot to me in the past 6 years of doing female impersonation shows and has helped me achieve and maintain a level that I've reached today, and that's Miss Michelle Lofton, Verna Vincent, my mother. And secondly, there's three press. Excuse me, pleasantly plump, wonderful, beautiful people who have taken me all over the United States this year and displayed me and showed me good times. Believe me, they are showing me good times. But I want to thank, and that's Dean, Michael, and Chuck from Sex Incorporated. And I'm going to do all my thank yous and get it over right now, and that is thank you to anyone who has ever helped me achieve what I have achieved in the past, and that includes all the past Miss Gay Missouris that have ever helped me do anything, the Miss Gay Americas that I have met this year, and every one of you from Missouri, because believe me, I don't know if you understand or if you can even comprehend at all how much this has meant to Dan Fleer to be up here tonight, let alone a year ago winning. This means more to me to be giving this up tonight than anything in the whole wide world. And I want you to understand that, and I want to thank all of you for supporting me for as long as you have. And I'm not going to bore you, but I have a few more things I want to say. In the years to come, I know that I can look over the pictures and remember the memories that I have to remember. And I can look back at when I started out at Helen Schrader's on the East Side and wore my own hair, and I graduated to what I have graduated today. And I don't know if you're proud of me, but I am awfully goddamn proud of me. Every good businessman, every good dancer, every good executive of any kind, anybody who works in a school teaching children, anyone who owns their own business and eventually gives it up to their son or their favorite employee or whatever the situation might be, knows when he sets his limits and knows when he sets his goals. This year I competed in Miss Gay America, and it was an experience I will never forget. I learned a lot. The people there are incredible. The friends that I have made this year are just, it goes beyond even explaining to you, not even including the Miss Gay Americas I've met, the past, the futures, the ones who competed this year. I set my goal last year at the Plantation Dinner Theater, and I worked, and I worked, and I worked to achieve what I achieved last year. And I won Miss Gay Missouri. I know that a lot of people don't understand someone giving up something that they love and feel that they are successful at and also feel that they are good at. But I set my goal a year ago, right on the stage of the Plantation Theater, and right now I am confirming my thoughts. I will never say never because that is too permanent, but I will say for a while, tonight I am putting Vanessa Vincent to rest, and I will appear as a former Miss Gay Missouri because I will always be Miss Gay Missouri 1982, and I couldn't be any more proud of that. And I know a lot of you don't know Dan, and I know a lot of you don't understand Dan, and that's
I
love you too, and that's irregardless. You will see what Dan proves to you in the future. I will always be here. I am so glad to be able to represent the state of Missouri this year, not only at the America pageant, but to be able tonight to stand here and speak publicly and let you know that there are people who do female impersonation who exist like me in the world. And for my numbers tonight, I chose something very appropriate, I think. And it's all about changing. And, you know, for the past 6 years, I've set goals for Vanessa Vincent. And I've achieved those goals. And like I said, she's proud of me. Believe me. But now it's time to move on, and it's time for me to set a few goals for Dan Flair. And by God, I'm going to do it. And this song is not only for all of you. This song is for me. Because I worked hard for it. So enjoy it, I hope.
community of St. Louis would like to thank you very much for Central Depot. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we finally come to that moment that you've been waiting for the last 9.5 hours.